And welcome back to another video. This time I'm going to demonstrate to you how we could upload resources to our learning management system. Before we start, I would like to show to you that I have here on my Finder, is the same as Windows Explorer, several resources that I'll be using. First, we have here the sample syllabus for the course, some PowerPoints, and then some assignments here. I also have, if you notice, several formats that I have here. We have here a PDF file, and then we also have here a document file. Okay, so I'll be using the resources later. Now, let's log into our learning management system. Again, the URL is mdsflms.com. Then you'll be prompted to ask, or you'll be prompted to enter your username and your password. In my case, I'm going to enter here as teacher, and then log in. Okay, so let's click login here. Once you have successfully logged in, you'll be redirected again to your dashboard. So this is the dashboard. So first things that you're going to see here in our main area, recently accessed courses. If you have several courses available in your site, so you'll be seeing here it here. So currently I have here LMS training. If you click the arrow here, it will go to another site. Okay, so if you scroll down, you'll be seeing here your course overview. So you could select this one here. You're going to see your in-progress courses, your future, your past, your started, or you could also remove this from the view. Okay, so again, let's go back here. And then I'll be opening the, let's open this learning LMS training course. So this is your canvas, this is your dashboard for your learning management training. So I already pre-populated some of the areas. If you were able to watch the previous video, so I was able to update the section, or this section here, that allows me to enter some of the details, okay? And then for this video, I'm going to upload here the course syllabus. So first thing is we must turn editing on. So how do we do it? So if you look at the gear icon here, if you click the drop down arrow, you're going to see here turn editing on. So click this menu. So once you click this menu, you're going to see several added icons. So it means that if you see this icon here, this pencil, this crosshair pointer, and then this area here, it means that we were able to add now different resources to our page, at the same time edit some of its resources. Now since we're going to add here a syllabus, again we have here our file, so open our Finder here. So I'm going to upload the file here. Okay, so to do that, you just simply look at this area, add an activity or resource, click this one. Okay, I'm adding it in this section. Okay, so add an activity or resource. So you're going to see here several activity resources that is available in our learning management system. So what I would like you to do is to select here, you scroll down to resources, and then you're going to select here your file, click this one, and then click add. So the next thing to do is that you're going to see this upload file section, or adding a new file. So what is required is the item that we have here. So if we need to identify here, or you need to place here the name, let's say course syllabus. Okay, and then this section here is the description of the file that you're going to upload. This is optional, but it will also be best that you somehow describe the item or file that you are uploading. So let's say this is the course syllabus, okay, something like that. And then make sure that you take this section here. So in this case, you're going to see the description in our course page. So let's scroll down. So the next step is for us to upload the file. So the simplest way for us to upload the file is to drag and drop the file into this box here. So to do that, open your Windows Explorer, in my case Finder, and then I have here a document file. So what I'm going to do here is to simply drag and drop the file to this section. So the file is now uploaded. Next step is you need to continue scrolling down. So from this point, I would like to mention that it is important that we click on activity completion. So activity completion allows us to track the movements of our students into our class. So every time that you're going to upload an activity or for, let's say, upload a file or create a quiz, I would suggest that you check this section here, activity completion, and then there are several options. So what I would like you to do here if we are uploading a file is that show activity as completed when conditions are met. Click this one here, select this option. Then you have to make sure that this item here is also selected. So why do we need that? If you would like to see whether students are viewing the materials that you have uploaded to the site, this area here will show us the, or will show us the details whether students have opened or clicked something into your site. After that, you scroll down, and then you need to save and return to course. Click this icon here, and then it will return back to this section. Okay. So again, this is the course syllabus, and then this is the description. So if you want to update or you want to upload another file, that's the first option here. I have another option. So this is the another approach. So I have here my Finder, and then we'll be uploading this PDF file. Let's assume that this is an updated syllabus. So all you need to do is to click, hold, and then drag, and then drag it to this section here. So as you can see, we are adding files here. Click on this one, and then the file will automatically be added to this section. Now, again, I mentioned that you need to turn editing on. So you just go back here and then edit settings. And then this this window will appear. And then maybe let's have this one, let's say, updated. And then you need to scroll down here. Activity completions, and then show activity as completed when conditions are met. Make sure this one is selected, and then save and return to course. Okay, so that's it. So aside from that, we will be also uploading several PowerPoints assignments into our course. So let's do that here. So let's assume that let's have this one on the second area here. Let's upload some PowerPoint file. So all you need to do is to click add an activity or resource. Okay, you scroll down, make sure that you select a file, click add. Okay, so this one here we're going to say, let's say, module 1, and then open your browser or your explorer rather. So in my case, I have here several PowerPoints. So I'm going to upload module 1. Click, hold, and then drag here. By the way, this section here. This is the course page description. This is module 1. And then click this item. Okay. So once you have uploaded the file, again, scroll down, select activity completion. Click this one here. And then simply save and return to course. Now, since another way to organize the file is for us to have several, let's say, naming conventions. So here, for example, if I go back to this section here, dashboard and general components of a course, if you click this pencil, you can now edit the item. So let's say this is section 1.0. Okay, enter. And then this one here, training part 1 will be 1.1. Okay, 1.1. Okay, that's it. So that would indicate the title and subtitle within a particular topic. Okay, so let's update this section here. So let's say this is 2.0. And then this section here is 2.1. So aside from module 1, you could also, let's say, update this one here, such as introduction to, let's say, in my case, computer science. Enter. And then this one here will be updated. Okay. Let's again update or add several items. Open my Finder again. Okay. So in this case, let's say I'll upload module 2 and then 3. So you can select this one. So select the file, just press ship. And then this would enable us to select multiple files. Click, hold, and then drag. So let's say you want to add the files here, and that's it. Okay. Then we could edit this one. So let's edit first the name. So this would be 2.2. And then the third one will be 2.3. Okay. Another thing, don't forget to turn editing on. The activity completion, okay? So click on edit, edit settings, scroll down, go to activity completion, show activity as completed, okay? Save and return to course. Make this as a habit, okay? Every time that you upload something or add something, make sure that you check this particular setting. So again, activity completion, this one here, and then save. I think that's the second one. Okay, so I think we have... Okay, now, if you notice, you could also interchange the position. Click, hold, and drag there. So you could simply move... How do you move? Let's try to move. Okay. Oh, it's not moving. Let's move it here, there. Okay. You could also have the capability to somehow indent it. So let's say we want to indent this particular module or PowerPoint. Click the drop down arrow here. You have to select the object, and then after that, move right. Okay, that will automatically indent. Now since we have indented it to the right, then you'll have the option here also to move it to the left. So if you want to move it again to the right, and then that's it. Okay, so this is how you upload files to our learning management system. As we progress, we will be adding other files such as document, PDFs, and others, and then I'll be showing it to you. Okay, so in our next video, I'm going to demonstrate configuring Gradebook. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Bye.